think. And the building's really old too, so it's kind of fun walking into this really musty old building. You're not really used to it, but it's kind of charming.
Space.
The
one thing that we have that others don't, especially when we look at other universities, is we have an enormous amount of space for art students to be able to spread out, use things, paint up on the walls, on the floors, on the ceilings. It's kind of anything goes. On top of that, we're able to offer up all of our Bachelor of Fine Art and Master of Fine Art students can get studio space, and then all the faculty get studio space. And so this is very uncommon at a lot of universities. In many cases, faculty have offices or very small studios, and they might throw 7 or 8 students maybe in a studio together. We're here, they have 1 or 2 students in a studio together. Friday, December. Officially, this building, because it's UK property and because it's the Reynolds building, which means we have a lot of equipment that is dangerous equipment. For instance, we have a foundry down in sculpture, and even in my studio, I have a gigantic paper guillotine cutter which can chop somebody's arm off. People actually aren't supposed to be in this building unless they are a registered student or a member of the university. Mm-hmm. So what happens is, on Open Studio, we opened up the doors to the public. And so parents come and just the general public just to get to come and see what we're doing. And we put artwork up everywhere. Every wall in this building is just covered floor to ceiling. All the studios are open for people to come in and check out work. They can buy work from the graduate students and undergraduates. And it's a gigantic party is basically what it is. It's a big art party.